So I'm happy to be invited at these events organized by the Axioma Project Gallery, and especially also in collaboration with Dimitri and all the Telecomuniste. So I am here to give a small introduction about the Resource for Transmedial Culture. That is a project that has been developed in Transmediale 2012, so the first Transmediale Festival with the new director Christopher Gansing. Also, I am the curator of this project, I am here to present a bit what is about. First of all, I would like also to connect it with the idea of networking. I don't know how many of you are familiar with this idea. I think maybe I would like also to involve you a bit in my presentation and try to ask you, if I say networking, what do you think about? What does it mean for you? Can I ask to you, what do you think networking means?
Networking means building relationships.
Great, I think that is really a great answer, and also not so many people answer in that direction, because I would say a lot, the idea of networking most of the time is really connected with technology and also with networks technology. That is true, but also for me what networking means is really to build up relationship. And so I have to say the Resource for Transmedial Culture started inside the Transmediale Festival also to try to create more deeper connection in the city of Berlin with the people that are working as artists, hackers, or activists. To give you also a bit an insight into the concept, I don't know how many of you know Transmediale Festival. Usually it's happening every February in the city of Berlin, and the last year, also some years, also the previous years, for many years, took place at the Haus der Kultur in der Welt, that is this building that you see. And it's a kind of huge European festival that is running for 5 days, and usually has always been happening in during 1 month, so beginning of February, end of January. And since this year, instead, we decide to start to develop a process that, as I say, is a networking process that was starting also before of the festival. And also, the idea was to make this festival going on, this process going on also after the festival. So this exhibition that you see here, the Axioma Project Gallery, is also our first international partner event of the resource, so it's also part of this stream. At the same time, in our idea of the Resource for Transmedial Culture, there is also a critical idea in what networking means, also trying to reflect on the role of cultural institutions that are engaging with art and technology, also reflecting critical on culture production. So that is why also this exhibition is really connected with what the resource is trying to do, and I would say also in this way we feel really connected also what Axioma Project Gallery is doing also, because they have always been sincere trying to develop a critical approach on what art, culture and technology means. The Resource for Transmedial Culture is also called in this way resource because if you go a bit more deeply into kind of techie culture, the source codes is the instruction that are forming the basis for every program. And so we thought maybe in this way we could create a process that is the source code for a distributed sharing process, and also playing a bit with the world, a common executable artistic program. So it's an artistic program that is really involving directly the local and translocal community of artists, hackers, activists in the city of Berlin, but also abroad. In fact, now we are in Ljubljana. One of the aspects that is really important for the resource is the idea of networking. I really like to show always this image that has been created by the male artist Vittore Baroni from Italy. is an image that he did in 1992. And it's really showing what networking means, at least at that time. It's a process that is also combining different media. And this is also close to the idea of transmedial, because you are not working with the computer only, for example, but in that time you were working with the postal art. Or you can work with photocopies, with cassette, with press, video, and with body as well, with phone. In fact, we are using the phone here together with the computer and the fax. And at the same time, it's also networking has been a term that has been used a lot also from the artistic avant-garde, especially Fluxus, for example, that were trying to change also the meaning of what an artistic process could signify, especially in the relation between the artist, the producer, and also the audience, trying also to involve the audience directly in the production of an artistic event or also an artistic project. And also the idea of mail art, this is another really funny image from Emilio Morandi, that is another mail artist from Ponte Nossa, that is also showing how mail art as a collaborative process was also trying to challenge what official art is, and also showing that art is easy. That is also a famous sentence from Giuseppe Chiari, a Fluxus artist coming from Florence. Inside the resource, another aspect that is also important is the idea of research. And I am also a researcher. I have finished a PhD at the Aarhus University in Denmark. Now I'm starting a postdoc. And I always thought that in organizing exhibition, that is also what I've been done in Berlin in the past years, there is always a really important aspect that is the one of making a research, and also the artists themselves for doing their work, they research. So the challenge is also trying to see in which way research could be combined with artistic practices, also trying to bring resource outside of the university. And for example, we thought that then the idea of research and also academic research could be brought into an agenda of an art festival like Transmediale. And what we did was to create a sharing process and a peer review process that was bringing together research practices and also the idea of curating a festival, for example, and also the idea of organizing events. So during the festival, we created a thematic publication, that is this one, and it's for free, so you can have one copy if you want. Somehow we did a hack as well, so we hacked the Murdoch newspaper News of the World. We created World of the News, and this is something that has been developed since last November when we did an event at the Universität der Kunst, bringing together different artists and also researchers. And inside you have a lot of contribution of people that are really reflecting in which way research and academic also research and artistic practice could intervene, and also trying to reflect on experimental modality of producing art. Inside, for example, there is also an article by Dimitri Kleiner that is speaking about venture communism. There is the description of the resource and a lot of other interesting articles, so I really suggest you to get a copy also, because basically we try to challenge the idea of peer review. That is usually something in academia you have really to work with to produce an article in a big journal. And so we basically decide to have a process before in a blog where each student that was part of this conference was actually peer reviewing the other paper of the other students. And so then we created this newspaper that is also a peer-reviewed newspaper and was presented during Transmediale. And finally, instead, the other part of the resource that is relating also to curating is really reflecting also in which way there could be a challenge between the fact that you are curating an artistic event and also you are involving the public and also the artist in having a sort of autonomy during this event. So this is the room of the resource of the for Transmedia Culture at Transmediale 2012. And during that festival, we tried to analyze five different thematic streams. One was a resource method that was really reflecting the discourse I told you before, bringing together research and art and artistic practices. But also we had the thematic stream of resource activism, where we reflected on new possible strategy of participation, also making a criticism of what activism means today, also after big change, for example, from what activism could mean in the hacker culture and the artistic context in the 90s, for example. So what does it mean activism today? And the resource network instead was also creating a meta-reflection on networking practices and also try to see how it's possible to use networking as a political strategy during conflict, but also as a strategy to overcome proprietary standard. And I think this exhibition here is completely expressing that, how it's possible to imagine a process of distributed network that are involving also randomly a collectivity of people that all together are creating a process that, for example, you know how it's starting and you don't know how it's finishing. In this way, also trying to, in this aleatoric component, trying to challenge the closeness of a lot of networking practices that have been developed after the Web 2.0, from Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter, that are all centralized. And another was the resource market that is also really connected, how to try to intervene in the financial process from within. And also we had the resource sex, trying to reformulate the concept of sexuality and pornography that was more belonging to the people themselves, also trying to challenge the idea of mainstream pornography. So here you have a bit of image, and at the same time we create a talk, but also a workshop, as you see here, the workshop activist beyond interfaces, from Roberta Bugliani and Alessandra Renzi. And so here are the five streams that I already mentioned. And I would say that one aspect that I would also reconnect directly with the exhibition of Telecomunista, and especially the work Alt 59, is really the one of trying to reflect on mutual interferences between art, business, and technology, but also bringing inside a playful component, a playful component that is also a disruptive component, because it's not only playful, but it's also critical. So I think also when Dimitri will present all the work, you can see especially how these things could be brought together. And I would say also in this room, you can really perceive an ironic component also while presenting a process and a project that is really radically critical on what networking means today. And so the challenge is to see how artists, hackers, activists, not so networkers, but entrepreneurs as well, can really act into business and market context, provoking disruption and art at the same time. And in fact, R59 was also a project presented initially at Transmediale. Define it official miscommunication platform of Transmediale, and the idea also was to engage the community of the festival, the visitors, the staff, and also the artists in being part of this network that then Dimitri will explain you deeply. And so, just to give a bit of practical information to conclude my presentation, in the idea also to continue this process of networking after the festival that is engaging the local and translocal community of Berlin, we are planning other free events, actually four, because this is also one part of that. And the next one will be in May, the 11-12 of general public in Berlin. And then in August, another cultural institution called Kunst am Kreuzberg Bethanien. And in November, we will do instead another research conference, as we did at the University der Kunst together with Aarhus University. But this time, we will do at the Leuphana University in Lüneburg. So if you pass to Berlin in that moment, you are really invited. And if you want to know more about the resource, of course, we have also a blog, then at the end I will give you the address. And just to conclude briefly, what we will do in this event is also try to reflect on thematic issues like networking, participation, culture production, and also the role of culture and art institution in a city like Berlin, but also abroad, and also trying to develop what will be the next transmediale topic that will be, of course, developed as part of the work of the team of Transmediale, but we also would like to have really this challenge, embrace this challenge of trying to reflect about the next topic also with the community that is part of the city of Berlin and all the people that want to participate at the next event. So this is the resource blog and my email contact if you want to know more. Thank you.